I'm Dave Epstein, this is Growing Wisdom, here with my friend Wayne Mezit. And Wayne, we're looking at a Florida dogwood, early bloomer of the dogwoods. This is one of the earliest. Tell us a little bit about the dogwood.
This is a native tree that grows along the East Coast. It's really only hardy to about zone 5. What looks like the flower is not a flower. It's the covering for the flower. The actual flower is right inside here. You can see the little yellow spots in there. Those are the flowers themselves. And the covering is the bract that you see that looks like the flower to most people.
So Wayne, folks may want a pink or a white or even a red blooming dogwood. They're really not getting a flower that's blooming. They're looking at a pink, a red, or a white bract.
That's right. Well, the native dogwood is pretty much white, although in the wild sometimes you see light pink ones. What the breeders have done is to select for darker colors. There's some now that are really pretty dark pink. They've been out for years and years. There's also some interesting leaf forms on the native dogwood. Sometimes they have variegated leaves, and sometimes they have a different growth forms. There is a weeping type of Cornus florida as well.
So what about care, Wayne, in terms of where should they plant them and disease susceptibility of these plants?
Dogwoods are sensitive to soil drainage. They need good, well-drained soil. They're also subject to a disease called anthracnose, which is a fungus that attacks the plants and can really do some serious damage to them. But recent years, it's been mild enough in the wintertime so that the stress is a little bit less on them. We see this sort of recovering. The most important thing is to choose a healthy plant to begin with. And also, the aftercare is important. It should be placed someplace where it has good soil drainage, good air drainage. In other words, so that there's enough air around it, and where it's not going to get hit with a lawnmower. So at the edge of the woods or in an area where it's mulched pretty well, because they're also susceptible to damage. And when you damage the trunk on them, they take a long time to heal.
If you had an arborist look at it, is there any treatments that they can provide?
It's always smart to make sure the fertility is right around the plants. You don't want to over-fertilize, but you don't want to starve them either.
How big do these guys get? You said leave enough room so there's a lot of airflow. How big are we talking?
As a dogwood matures, it grows up and wide. One of the best features of it is its horizontal branching. But it's going to get 25 or 30 feet tall in most gardens. If it's in a warmer area, zone 6 or 7 or 8, it's going to get even bigger.
Wayne, thank you very much. I love the dogwood. It's a great plant, and you should have one in your home if you have the room for it. We appreciate it. Come back every week for all of our tips, hints, and helps here at Growing Wisdom.